Hi everyone, it's Vanessa Owase. I hope you guys are doing well. Welcome to my kitchen. And today I'm gonna show you how to cook a pan-fried fish fillet sauce.
A pan-fried fish fillet sauce. Do I sound like a Kardashian?
All right, let's go. So for this recipe, we're gonna need, for this pan-fried fish fillet sauce recipe, we're gonna need, of course, two sliced fish fillets, and about four tablespoons of all-purpose flour, five tomatoes, large tomatoes, I've already sliced them, and for the sauce, we're gonna need fish masala. These are the powder spices, fish masala, curry powder, black pepper, and 1 teaspoon of salt. And all of these are, apart from the sauce, others are just teaspoons. As for the salt, it's tablespoons. I hope you guys know the difference. And we're also gonna need one large onion. I used the red onion. You can just use any onion of your choice. I used one bell pepper. I used the green one because it looks good. You can use a red or yellow. And I have a thumb, or let's say a half thumb of ginger, one chili pepper, and about 6 or 7 and a half garlic cloves. We're also gonna need some canned tomato, and I choose salsa because it's the one I had. And yeah, you guys can choose any of your choice. You can use any of your choice. And I have some fresh thyme. This is a very important ingredient in this recipe. It's really important because it adds some flavor and it adds some very good fresh smell. And we're gonna need some oil. I use olive oil. You can use any of your choice. And of course, I have a glass of wine to boost my energy. Now let's get started. First off, we're gonna take our blender. We're gonna drop in our sliced tomatoes. I used 5. You can use as many as you want according to how many people are gonna take your sauce. And then we're gonna take our half thumb of ginger. Don't put too much, just a half thumb is enough. And our garlic cloves. Remember to add in a little bit of water, just not too much, just a little bit to create a little bit of a sauce. And then mix properly. Close and blend. I'm just gonna go ahead and switch on the stove. There you go. And put on your pot. Mine is dry, but if you don't have a dry pot, just make sure you dry it or you wait a few seconds for the water to dry off, and then put 4 tablespoons of oil. 4. Don't go over 4 tablespoons of oil. Make sure the oil is hot. You're gonna know that the oil is hot if it starts making a sound, or if you're not sure, just drop in something. It could be a piece of bell pepper or a piece of anything, literally. If it starts making that sound, then you know you're going to put everything else inside. You know it's going to be ready. I mean, you know the oil is ready. All right. So I guess I'm just gonna go ahead and put in my onion and bell pepper. Careful, you gotta put your face away from the fire, from the oil. Crazy. I like using this because I love my hands too much. I don't want my hands to burn. So you gotta have a piece of clothing with you. The reason why we stir, we want the oil to get everywhere. Everywhere in the bell peppers, in the onion. Just make sure you stir. And then cover the pot. Cover all your pots with it. Don't leave any space hanging with nothing. And cover the pot. These should be well done in 2 minutes. When it's 3 minutes, that means they're starting to become black. They're ready. Remember, I told you guys that this is a teaspoon each, apart from the salt, which that is 1 tablespoon. So what we're gonna do, we're just gonna take half of each, half of the fish masala, half of the black pepper, half. I'm sorry about the noise, I have too many visitors coming over. Half of the curry powder and half of the salt. You gotta get fast before your onions start becoming black. Alright. Stir everything together. The smell is amazing! Stir everything together. They just gotta, your onions have to catch up on the color, the taste, and the smell. And then these powders tend to stick on the pot down. So to avoid that, just put a little bit of water, just like one. Two drops of water. Stir. Remember, we are on medium heat. I don't know if I had said that before, have I? I did. Yeah, we're on medium heat, and then that's when you grab your tomato, your canned tomato. Use a spoon to get all of it from the container. Do you hear this sound? It's amazing. Take it off. Take everything. And then make sure you stir until everything looks red. And they marry together. And then as it all looks red, as you can see, that's when you are going to add your blended, remember, chili pepper, garlic, ginger, and tomatoes. Whew. And of course, we're gonna add a little bit of water. Not too much. You don't want your sauce to be too soft. You want it to be really thick. Take everything off and then stir. You gotta stir. Stir everything together. Do you hear this? This is amazing. Yeah, you stir. I'm sorry. I can hold myself like this. Smells amazing. And then, see, I'm swallowing my saliva. It's too good. Then you gotta reduce your fire to a low heat. To a low heat, and then you let it cook by itself. There you go. Meanwhile, remember we have our fish fillet aside. And this is the time we are going to marinate it. So to marinate it before cutting it, remember we still have half of our spices. And what we are going to do, and among our spices, of course, we have salt. We're going to put the rest of the half. I mean, the half of the rest. We're gonna put the rest here in the all-purpose flour. You can use a hand, but remember to clean your hands, wash them, and then mix everything together. Look at this. Even the color changes, the smell changes, believe it. Make sure that even mix everything together. I had to clean my hands to cut the fish because we're about to cut the fish. And sorry about my fiance, he's crazy. And right now we're gonna cut the fish. I like to cut it into 4 pieces. You can cut it into as many pieces as you want, depending on how you like it, if you like small pieces or big pieces. I just like to cut it into 4. As you can see, I have 2 fillets, so it's obviously going to be 8 pieces. Also, you have to make sure that your fillet is dry. You have to put it aside to make it dry, and you gotta pat it off. Before you cut it, before you prepare everything, pat it off, remove the excess water, and here you go. What is 1, 2, 3, 4? Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Still like have 3 more to go. Here you go. Last but not least, this is a big fillet. I don't know. I am tempted to do to do other pieces. You know, they're already cut off, and it's a big fillet. It's a big mama right here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut this bad girl into 2. You go. So what we're gonna do, this combination of spices and all-purpose flour is going to serve this fillet this way. Make sure you cover the whole fillet with it, part off the excess flour, put it aside one by one. Sorry for the mess. One by one. Part of the excess. Make sure you cover all the fillet, part of the excess, put it aside. Carefully, you don't wanna be like me, making a mess while cooking. You don't wanna clean and cook all at the same time. No time to waste. Why am I sounding like a Kardashian? Am I? Last but not least, here you go, remember to put in all the corners with the flour and spices in all the corners, part of the excess, and kaboom. I gotta wash my hands first. Right, I think our sauce is ready. It's boiling already. It's boiling. When you see something boiling like this and the, what is it? The oil is already on top and it's separating itself from the rest, you know that it's ready. Cover it, put it aside, and on the same stove, you guys, ta-da, put on a pan. Like the pots, the same thing as the pot, you gotta clean off the pan. Make sure the pan is waterless, if that's a word. Make sure it's dry because you're gonna put in some oil. You need 4 tablespoons of oil. Make sure they cover. You know what? I measure. When I'm gonna put it in here, when I'm gonna put the oil here, I use tablespoons. That's why the first tablespoons were for here and the second tablespoons were here and there were four, and now it's over. So yeah, I put 8 tablespoons. If you don't know how to measure it, you can just use your tablespoons instead of a container. And then put the fire up, put the heat up. Remember, we had reduced our heat to low, so you gotta do medium low. It's never recommended to use like a very huge heat. So when the oil is hot, this is when you put in your fish fillet, your marinated fish fillet. I like to use this. Don't overcrowd them and make sure you fry them for 2 to 3 minutes. 2 to 3 minutes, they'll be already like golden brown. You can use your phone to see the time or something else. I don't know, as long as you don't exceed 3 minutes. I usually do 2 minutes because the time I have to change is also gonna add up to the minutes, so it's going to be, you know, almost 3 minutes by the time they're all on the other side. So after 2 minutes or 3 minutes on each side, you gotta turn your pieces of fish fillet and then wait for 2 to 3 minutes again. All right, as you can see, our fish fillet is fried already. We are still on low heat. We don't need medium or high heat anymore because literally everything is already done. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab our fish fillet, our fried fish fillet. We put it in the sauce one by one. You just gotta be careful, otherwise you're gonna end up with a sauce full of pieces, you know. Here, one by one, slowly, carefully. And by the way, you guys, I use this because you want all the oil to dry off, so this piece of paper, tissue paper, it helps it get off all of it. Some people like to use those containers that are like pointy down, but the tissue paper, it does magic. See, it's already dry, so I couldn't even put any oil inside. Last piece, I am trying to be as patient as possible, but this smell is not gonna allow me. So stir just slowly, carefully. You don't want them to turn into pieces. Remember, everything is already cooked, well cooked. All you need is for the temperature of the sauce that you had already removed from the stove. So that means it was already cooled off. So you need that temperature to marry the temperature of the fish fillet, the fried fish fillet. Y'all remember this? This, the thyme. You gotta use a tablespoon, one tablespoon, because these bad boys, they can have a very strong smell. It's a good smell, but when it's too much, it doesn't smell good. So make sure it's just, you can have fresh thyme, or you can use these ones. It's not like too big of a difference. Just make sure they don't exceed, you don't exceed like one tablespoon. Here you go. Stir a little bit. Oh, they smell so good. Oh, can you guys smell this? Yeah? Stir a little bit. Mm-hmm. Not too much. You don't want to crush your fish. You don't want to crush it. And then you're just going to cover the pot. Cover it only for like 1 minute for the thyme to blend in, to enter, to enter all the fish. All the fish or the soup, and then after 2 minutes, you're gonna be ready. All right, I just opened after 3 minutes. Look at this. Look at this. I just don't want to hurt my fish. We're just gonna go ahead and serve and taste. Woo! Always remember to switch off your stove. Here you go. Wow, I hurt them a little, but it's not too much. That's why you gotta be delicate with fish. Here you are. I just want to add a little bit of sauce because I want you guys to see the sauce. There you go. The moment I've been waiting for. Let me get a fork. Looks so yummy. It smells so good. You guys, a moment of silence. No, yo, this is so good. I hope you guys remember to subscribe. Hit the notification bell so that you don't forget. You don't forget that I exist, that this meal exists. Also, that you don't miss on any video. And I have so much more in store for you. I gotta hit this. And you guys, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.